Hello guys, hello designers. Today I want to speak to you about color palettes in Procreate. I'm only gonna explain you how to quickly save a new color palette and how to export or import a color palette from somewhere if you purchased it or you want to sell your own or you want to share your palette with somebody else. So this video is only dedicated to this purpose. Right, so where do the color palettes live? I'm going to use this illustration I've created previously, and we will work with this five colors, five or six, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven colors, and that's pretty much it. Okay, so let's have a looky. So once you go into the colors page under Procreate, you will see that there is a palettes option available at the very right bottom corner. You may not have these color palettes like I do, but I already am quite organized, so I already saved quite a few here. So let's try to add the color palette from the illustration that you can see here. It doesn't have to be illustration, could be a simple photo. So all you need to do is press this plus here, and then you will get an option. You can create a new palette from an illustration and image on here on the Procreate page. You can enter new from camera, from file, or from a photo. I suggest let's do this create new palette, a traditional way of creating palette first, and then we can compare it to one of these options because these are quite cool. So I think it's interesting to know. Okay, so I press create new. So Procreate will insert a space here for me to create a color palette. So all I need to go to do now, so I'm just going to close the palettes for a minute. I'm going to press here in this square, and that will allow me to start searching for colors on my illustration and the image. So this is all you're doing. So you're picking the color and you're going back to your color palette and you press here exactly where you want to add this new color swatch, and Procreate will remember that. So let's do the other four or five. Okay, this one, and I'm gonna go back. I think I have a darker here, and I have a slightly more orangey here, and then I've got a couple of greens. So it's this one, and then the slight green here. Alright, so I have a color palette of six, and let's say you're happy with it. So let's just rename it so we are well organized and remember what that was inspired by. I do a lot of color palettes inspired by city breaks or like places around the world. So this one, autumn in Paris, Venice, Roman holidays. So I like to give my color palettes names. So in fact, to rename it, you just have to tap on untitled, and then I will just say, let's call it test for now, which is good enough. Okay, so this is that you saved color palette and you've done it manually, and you call it test. So let's compare how that's going to look like if you do it using a different option here. And I already saved that as a photo in my images. So let's compare how the creating a new color palette from a photo compares to the one that you've just done manual. I think it's just cool option to have. So let's try new from photos. Let's try find the illustration here, and you see it's quite interesting because Procreate, and instead of like six images that I manually picked from the image, it added me like I don't know, 45 swatches, and these are really the in-between shades of these colors, that six colors that I have here. So depending on what your preferred option, you can basically choose for yourself which one you like. You don't also have to, if you prefer like a compact view of all your color swatches, you can look at it under this page here, but then you can switch into the cards, which looks more like reminds me of Pantone colors, and the way they present them could be useful for somebody else, but I prefer to look at it in a more compact manner. So this is it. That's me saving and renaming a new color palette, and I explained how to do that. So now let's see, for example, What if you want to share this color palette with somebody? For example, I sell these color palettes on Etsy, so I need to export that color palette and send it to the potential buyer. Or what you could do, you could save the color palette in the Procreate, export it to another program. Let's say, I don't know, Illustrator or Affinity Designer or any other program that you use. So to do that, you just press on these three dots here. In fact, I'm just going to use this. And then you press share. And that's it. Once you press share, it is exporting. It is suggesting you like places where you want to. You can send it to your other device if you want it. I will save it into my colors. You see, I already have a Procreate color palette within my iCloud files. So this is it. I'm not going to save it because I already have it. So we're just going to go back in Procreate. The very last thing I wanted to show you today is how to import a color palette. Let's say you create it in a different application, or somebody else wants to share a color palette with you, or you simply purchase it online. So it's the easiest thing in the world to do. So you again press this plus button here, and then you add new from file, right? And then this program is going to look up a folder. I already have a folder in my iCloud folders, which is called Procreate Color Palette, where I saved everything I've done before. And let's say I'm going to choose this file, and you see it's adding a color palette that I've previously created, and it seamlessly adds it to the Procreate swatches folder, and it even picks up the name of the file. This is it. This is the easiest thing to do. So let me know if I missed anything, or let me know if you know an other cool way of using those color palettes optionality within Procreate, and let's keep in touch. Thanks very much.